You're now tuned in to the Real Money Coach broadcast with host Tony Jackson, author of the book Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money. Get ready for winning tips and strategies to effectively manage your finances and learn the key principles of protecting and dominating your money. Now, here's author and host Tony Jackson.
Welcome, 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 and good morning. You are listening to the Real Money Coach Show here on Praise 100.9, Charlotte's Inspiration Station, and everywhere, everywhere that you get your podcasts, I am there. Listen, I'm excited about today. I'm excited about this month. And I tell you what, one of the things I'm excited about is because this is Women History Month, and we are going to, what I thought I'd do this month for the month of March is just share a couple entrepreneurs, trailblazers, if you will, in terms of Black women in business. And so I'm gonna do that at the beginning of the show for the rest of the month in the first segment. In our second segment of the show today, we have a interview with Larry Jones, DJ Larry Jones. You are going to be inspired by his story. I promise you, you will be inspired. And in the last segment of today's show, I will again feature a little bit of our class that we're doing, the TRMC University Financial Literacy class. Once again, that is every Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time on Zoom. You can register at trmcmasterclass.com. Last week, we talked about savings and budget, so I'll share a little bit of that information with you on the last part of today's show. So if we're going to be talking about a Black entrepreneur and female, you know the first name that comes up is Madam C.J. Walker, right? Madam C.J. Walker, pioneer. And she is the first. Now, listen, we often talk about, you know, Black millionaire, but she is the first American female self-made millionaire of all races. So that's really a big deal. Obviously, we know her story's been documented. There's been series on it. There's been movies about it. But Madam C.J. Walker was a bad sister. Her real name was Sarah, right? And so she, as we know, started the hair care products. Y'all, I'm getting it out. Hair care products, and became a millionaire with the Madam C.J. Walker Manufacturing Company. It was wildly, wildly successful profits. And, you know, if it was modern day dollars and we were doing time value, she'd be a probably a billionaire. But we know that she'd be worth several million dollars. And she made a lot of contributions, you know, beyond just with her sales force, which was phenomenal. It was the forerunner to what we see in a lot of things now. In terms of even like, I think Amway and some other things, her methods, her things, her sales force and how she worked with them and how she trained them was legendary. But, you know, even with that, she put six students through Tuskegee Institute, and she also became active in the anti-lynching movement. She gave thousands of dollars to the NAACP movements. And, you know, what's interesting is about the anti-lynching. You know, the law just passed here not a couple years ago. Isn't that sad? Now, the other one, the other person I want to talk about, and what I'm doing here is I'm going like history, like 1800s, you know, Madam C.J. Walker, and then our next person. And then each week I'll just come up a decade and talk about someone new until we get to modern day. And the one thing that we know is there's so many Black women who are just rocking it in the business world. So I don't know how I'm going to narrow it down to just a few. But today, our second person I want to talk about is Bridget Mason, also known as Biddy. And she was actually born a slave, and she became one of the richest women in Los Angeles. And she was a real estate and an investor, a midwife. She bought her freedom, right, with the help of her white son-in-law named Charles Owens. So she had a couple children that were actually fathered by her slave masters. One was named Robert Smith, and then she had a couple others. And she moved to Utah and then became a church leader and then eventually settled in Los Angeles. And that's where she made her empire in terms of real estate. And I know oftentimes, you know, we're looking at real estate in terms of a great way to invest. And as you know, here on A Real Money Coach, that's one of our four pillars. And let me remind you of those four pillars of intergenerational wealth change. That being, number one is proper money management. And that's what our money class is all about. You know, getting your credit right, getting your debt, you know, getting out of debt, loans, debt, credit, insurance, investing, all those things. So just managing your money. And of course, it all starts with the mindset. So that's the first pillar. The second pillar is having the proper insurance investments. Unfortunately, you know, a lot of us, in terms of, I'm talking the black and brown community, we don't have proper insurance in place. In fact, the New York Times put out a study that said that in black America, you are 10 times more likely to have insurance on your cell phone than you would on your life. Listen, GoFundMe ain't a life insurance policy, y'all. Y'all better get covered. You better call me and get that thing straight. And then our other pillar is, of course, real estate. Real estate, real estate, real estate. And then the fourth pillar is business development. So when we have our guests on the show, when we do our classes, it's usually surrounding those four pillars. Sometimes we venture a little bit off because we have stories that are very awesome and very worth bringing on the air. But those are our four pillars. She was involved in real estate, had acquired a fortune of about $300,000 at the time, by the late 1800s in Los Angeles. Today's value, that would be $6 million in today's value. And so Miss Bridget Mason was nobody's joke. And so she was a entrepreneur, very successful. And so we have a lot of great examples of that. And so I just want to share a little bit of that news with you, a little bit of that history as we go through Women's History Month. Listen, this is the Real Money Coach Show, and I'll be right back with our interview with Mr. Larry Jones, DJ Larry Jones. You're listening to the Real Money Coach Show.
Times I didn't know how I'd make it through. I had no other choice but to put my trust in you. Many have found me and others let me down. But you were so consistent, no greater love I found. It's in you, I can depend, it's in you. I know I'll always win, it's in you. It's with you. I don't have to cry anymore. I don't have the pain no more.
Hey, Grace family, join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
Hey, Tony Jackson here. You know me as The Real Money Coach. Listen, I want to encourage you to do something. And what I want to encourage you to do is email me your questions, your comments, or even suggestions that of topics that you'd like us to cover on the Real Money Coach Show. You can email it to info@therealmoneycoach.com. Again, that's info@therealmoneycoach.com. Email us your questions, your comments, your suggestions, and we will answer those on air and also on our Facebook Live YouTube show on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. So make sure you email us so that we can get that information that you want to know in your ears. I am Tony Jackson, the Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
All right, all right, all right. Welcome, 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 welcome back to the Real Money Coach Show here on Praise 100.9 in every place you get your podcast. As I mentioned to you in the early part of the show, I'm excited about who I have on the line with me.
It is Larry Jones. Let me say this. DJ Larry Jones, man. And he has a great following. He's been in this space for a long time. He has his own radio show, and it airs on Indie Central TV, streaming on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, all of that. Larry is on the line. Larry, how you doing?
Oh, man, I'm doing very, very well, man. Thank you for having me on the show here today. It's you know, you got a good thing happening here. I love your platform. Thank you for having me.
I appreciate it, especially that coming from you, Mr. Power Hour, right? So yes. I love it, man. So, man, for our listeners who are tuning in, who may not know Larry Jones, I mean, maybe they've been sleeping under a rock. Maybe they don't know who Larry Jones is. Man. Tell the folks a little bit about who's Larry Jones.
All right, a little bit about me, man. I was born and raised in New York City. I'm not going to get into it in depth, but I was born and raised in New York City, man, and dipped and dabbed in some music for a while, the music business. Worked with Master P and Little Romeo on a nice project. And the music industry, it really wasn't for me. I mean, I love music, love being around it, but the actual industry wasn't for me. So I decided to come out of that and into radio. Worked on a radio station in Virginia for a while. And once the pandemic hit, they wasn't allowing anybody to go into the station. So I started doing my interviews online and interviewing various celebrities like Regina Bell, a whole bunch of people, Faith Evans, Ed Gordon. The list goes on and on. Every Love and Hip Hop reality star you can name has been on the show. Just a lot of people, a lot of people. And now I'm here. The show airs, like you said, on Indie Central TV, and that streams on Roku and Amazon Fire TV. And the viewership is really good. I'm proud of what the show is, and I'm proud of where it's going.
Man, that's pretty awesome, man. You just dropped a few names, man, like, you know, just casually. Regina Bell, Ed Gordon, right? Faith Evans, man. So you've been talking to some folks, man. So man, tell us, you know, what's your passion, man? What kind of drives you?
You know what? The show drives me. It really, really pushes me. I watch various interviewers, and I pull a little bit from, believe it or not, Howard Stern, Steve Harvey. I pull a little bit from them. They kind of drive me to do what I do. Even Charlamagne Tha God, shout out to him. They kind of drive me to do what I do. And, you know, I love it. I love it.
Man, that Breakfast Club, I mean, that's something special, man. That's pretty dope. And so, man, I know that you kind of relocated to the North Carolinas here, you know, not far from me and Charlotte, not far from the station and all that. So what brought you to North Carolina?
A change. You know, I got sick and tired of, I don't want to say, let me take that back. I didn't get sick and tired of being in New York. I love New York, love where I come from. But I did want that change. I felt like I couldn't. And they say that's the city. If you can make it there, you can make it anywhere. And that's true. But for me, I wasn't making it. You know what I mean? Right. I felt like I had to go out to go back in. I had to do what I had to do outside of New York. New York can be, have a lot of distractions, you know, and I just felt like I had to go out and do my thing, and it worked out just the way I said. Not to mention, had some family issues. You know, I was no saint.
Yeah, life happens, right?
life happens. Had family issues, and I'm just gonna keep it all the way real with you. Mom's putting me out the house. You know what I mean? So North Carolina's where I ended up.
Man, you know, I love that, man, because, you know, keeping it real is one of the things that we definitely want to do. You know, when you come on the show live on Facebook and YouTube on Tuesday, is we want to know the real story, right? We want to know what really kind of, you know, what drives you and what kind of experiences you've had that you can share. You know, one of the things, man, that I thought was just kind of interesting as I was looking at your profile and your bio, is that you were on a station in Charlottesville, Virginia. And we all think of Charlottesville now because of the whole incident down there with the Proud Boys
and, you know, the former president saying there were good people on both sides and all this type of stuff. What was Charlottesville really like?
Here's the thing. The show was actually done remotely. I only went there when it was like a something going on, a concert or a festival in the park. Then I went there. But when I got there, it was okay. You know what I mean? I didn't experience anything negative like that, any racism or anything like that. It was okay. I did what I had to do, and I got out of there. Now, would I live there? Probably not. But it's a great place. I mean, I like it. So I didn't feel that tension when I was there.
Right, right. And I have friends, even business partners, went to UVA and all this kind of stuff. And so, but, you know, that's one of the things too, man, is like, you know, you make the best of where you are. And, you know, we just do what we do, right? We stay focused, came in, you took care of business, it came on out, sounds like.
Right.
So that's pretty cool. So, man, on Tuesday, give us a little bit about what you're going to share with us, with the live audience on Tuesday. What's on your mind? Okay. What you going to share?
This is what I'm going to share. I'm going to share abuse, growing up in the household with domestic violence. My dad was an alcoholic. And he would physically abuse my mom. I was little, and I had to deal with that. A lot of stuff, man, from being kicked out of the house. Even now, and I want to say this, I have a sister, God bless her, she's in the hospital right now, and she's going through cancer, and it's not really looking too good. And I have a mom who says, I don't care. That's not my daughter. For whatever reason, I don't know. You know what I mean? So we'll talk about that. We're going to get into it. We are going to get growing up hungry. And don't get me wrong. I don't want to put the blame and point the finger at my mom. You know what I mean? I'm not here to bash her or to make her, you know, put her in a dirty light. That's not what I'm doing. I'm just speaking my truth and just talking about how I've risen above it and became the person I am today.
Man, I love that. It's just overcoming the circumstances, man. That's the theme there, man. So listen, I really appreciate you taking some time out to be with us this morning. Much prayer for your sister and your family. And man, I can't wait to unpack this even more on Tuesday. Listen, you guys are listening to DJ Larry Jones. And he's going to be on our show Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, Facebook, YouTube Live. You're listening to The Real Money Coach Show. We're going to take a quick break. I'm going to come back and close out our show for today. This is Praise 100, Charlotte's Inspiration Station.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Come on now. I know y'all ain't got to stand there and look. It ain't over. This thing ain't over. Come on, somebody. We're going to take this thing out right. Listen, he who dwells in
shelter,
he who dwells in
shelter,
who dwells in
shelter,
who dwells in shelter, who dwells in
shelter,
say shelter,
shelter,
say
shelter,
everybody, say shelter,
shelter,
come on, Detroit,
shelter.
I hear you, say shelter.
Shelter
of the Most.
Family, join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
Hey, Tony Jackson here. You know me as The Real Money Coach. Listen, I want to encourage you to do something. And what I want to encourage you to do is email me your questions, your comments, or even suggestions that of topics that you'd like us to cover on the Real Money Coach show. You can email it to info@therealmoneycoach.com. Again, that's info@therealmoneycoach.com. Email us your questions, your comments, your suggestions, and we will answer those on air and also on our Facebook Live YouTube show on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. So make sure you email us so that we can get that information that you want to know in your ears. I am Tony Jackson, the Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
All right. Welcome back to the show. I am Tony Jackson, your host, the Real Money Coach. Listen, I know that you enjoyed that few minutes of interview with Larry Jones, DJ Larry Jones. Make sure that you dial in, log in, watch us on your iPhone, your iPad, your computer, whatever device you have, Tuesday, 8 p.m. Eastern Time on Facebook and YouTube, where we'll get a chance to really unpack Larry's story. And again, I think you're going to leave that inspired, right? You're going to be leave it inspired. You're going to be informed. So I'm very much looking forward to you being with us on Tuesday evening. And then, you know, share this recording, share this show with your family and friends. It is going to be dropped as a podcast, usually about 10 a.m. on Saturday mornings. We're live on the air at 7:30. By 10 a.m., the podcast is out there on all platforms. Now, what I mentioned to you this month, and we are doing our TRMC masterclass, financial literacy masterclass, financial intelligence. And, you know, I talked about this before. How do I distinguish between what is financial literacy and what is financial intelligence? Financial literacy to me is just getting the information. Financial intelligence is actually putting it to use. This last week, what we had is we went over budgeting and savings. And so I'm just going to share a little bit of the highlights with you. This was led by one of my team members who's a CPA, Valerie Rhodes, out of Atlanta, Georgia. She facilitated the class. But we talked about just the fundamentals of budgeting. And, you know, what is a budget? I mean, a budget is basically a finance plan that allocates your personal income towards expenses, savings, and debt repayment. It's just kind of that simple. And, you know, I think we also sometimes call it a savings plan because people say budget and they got a negative connotation. And, you know, one of the things that we polled everyone who was registered for the class, who attended the class, which is about 170 people. And by the way, I don't know if I mentioned it. It is free. And we polled them and 63% of the people said the reason they don't budget is because they don't know where to start. And then the next poll was, you know, the next one on the list really was the reason people don't budget is because it's too hard. And so what we want to do is we want to make it simple. Make sure that you come and check out the class. But so that's the definition of a budget, is just allocating your income, expenses, savings, and debt repayment plan. Now, income, what is income? Income is all the money that you get from all the resources, right? It's like your job. It's your side hustle. It's wherever you're getting income. Account for those things. And then expenses, you know, what you're paying out to others, and then, of course, savings. Now, what I really want to talk about this is how we kind of take a little different approach, because the normal approach to budgeting is this. I get my income, and then I take out all my expenses, and then what's left goes to savings. And what we believe is this. We believe that savings has to be number three on your budget. For me, it's number three. So what's number one? Number one is income. Number two for me is tithes. Number three is savings. And then everything else. And so we want to just be clear on that. And that's the other thing I talk about is if you're going to get a money mentor or someone that's going to be helping you with your money, your finances, a financial coach like me, is make sure that their beliefs align with your beliefs so that you can make sure that you're equally yoked with the people that you're working with in terms of putting together your financial plan. But anyway, so I'm not going to get off on that. Y'all come see me if y'all want to hear some more about that or email me and we can have that conversation. So we got our income, we got our tithing, we got our savings. So rather than savings being the afterthought, we need to move it up in the process. And then the other thing is I have a little different twist on what is called variable expenses and fixed expenses. Here's my definition of a fixed expense. I don't look at a fixed expense as something that's the same every month. I look at it as a necessity, right? It's like, for example, here in North Carolina, we got Duke Energy. Back home where I'm from in Michigan, we got Consumers Energy, right? Now, my energy bill is not the same every month, but I better pay it or I ain't gonna have no lights. So that's a fixed expense to me. That's something that I have to pay regardless if it fluctuates. Now, you can get on a payment plan where your amount is even every month and all that. But when you think about fixed expenses, think about the things that you have to have. You got to have shelter. You got to have your utilities, your car insurance, different things that you have to have. Those are fixed expenses. To me, variable expenses, again, are things that maybe I don't necessarily need, right? Maybe I don't need 5 streaming services. Maybe I can get on your account. But you don't need all of those. So variable expenses are things that may be a little different in terms of I don't necessarily need it. And so whenever we start talking about budgeting and we start talking about money, we really have to think about the concept of needs versus wants. And a good example I use for that is like I need a car, right? But what I really need is transportation. I may need a car, but it doesn't have to be a Mercedes. And so the Mercedes may be a want, but the transportation is a need. So there are different various ways to look at these things. And it's important that you just spend some time unpacking the whole thing about having a budget. The most important thing is to have one. And also sometimes you got to give yourself some forgiveness, right? Because oftentimes what happens is we fall off our budget and we get discouraged and we don't want to get back on it. I tell you, it's like riding a bike. Get back on it as many times as you need to. Get back on program. Get back on your budget wagon and continue to work at it. It is a work in process. You may always struggle with it in some ways. Some people, it's natural. We're all different. But the most important thing, make sure that you budget. Listen, you have been listening to the Real Money Coach Show here on Praise 100.9. I hope you enjoy your Saturday. And remember to tune in on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern, Facebook and YouTube for the Real Money Coach Show. I'm out.
We hope you've enjoyed the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host Tony Jackson. We encourage you to utilize today's strategies and principles to manage your money in the most effective and winning way. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to send us an email, tonyjacksonagency@gmail.com, or you can reach us on all social media platforms. And if you would like a copy of Tony Jackson's book, Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money, log on to www.therealmoneycoach.com. Until next week's empowering broadcast, God bless.